Hi everyone, Chef from Outdoors in the Low Countries. And we like to do woodworking, and as we all know, for woodwork you really need to have sharp tools. Now I looked around to see what's the ideal tool for making and keeping the planer blades and chisels sharp. And the one that I prefer most is the Tormek T8. So why did I choose the Tormek? Well, first of all, because it's a wet grinding system. And with dry grinding systems, you will have very high temperatures, especially at the cutting edge, because the heat cannot go away from that point. And as a result, you will, in many cases, have softening of your metal. And that's exactly what you don't want when you want to have your chisel or your cutting blade or your planer blade. It will be sharp, but it also will become soft. Now that's a large advantage of the Tormek system, because it will never become hot because it is being water cooled while it's being grinded. Another advantage is the universal bracket, because that you can use to make sure that your angle of your cutting device is always according to what you need to have. And because they also include the conditioning stone, you will have rough grinding and fine grinding in one setup, as well as the honing wheel. So with this system you have all the things you need to sharpen your tools properly. So let's unbox the Tormek and see what's inside. Now, apart from the T8, there's also the T4, which is a little bit smaller. But I choose the T8 because it is a larger system. And I really also want to sharpen the blades for the planer thicknesser, which are quite long. And that's why I really prefer the T8. So it's a little bit more expensive than the T4, but I think it will pay back when I'm going to sharpen the longer blades. So let's open the box and see what's inside. So here you see the top side of the box. It comes with the SE77 that you can use for the planer blades. That's of course what I like. This one with the diamond for dressing the stone. Angle measurement. Dressing stone. Leather honing wheel oil. Oh, this is an edge marker. This is for marking the edge of your cutting device, so you can see that the angle has been properly aligned. Honing compound, also for the honing wheel. Now what's in this? So, in here they even included some band-aid, which of course makes sense if you have very sharp tools. Let's hope you don't need them. And some manuals as well. Now this is a very extensive piece of work on the sharpening, which is interesting. Here we have the extra wide blade for catching the water, the magnet, 12mm thick rail system. So the nut is left turning, which it means locking is contra-intuitive. So with this knob you can turn the water reservoir up and down. Now this is a small scraper that you can use to scrape out the metal parts. And you can click it over here to easily collect all the parts together, so it's easily cleanable. So let's power it up, see whether it will run. So apparently you need to freshen up the drive wheel, because there might be some film. Let's do that. So there's a clear getting started manual. So first sandpapering the driving wheel, which I did. Now preparing the leather honing wheel. Impregnate the leather with the oil included. Use approximately 2/3 of the tube. It will soften the leather and cause the honing compound to penetrate. Okay. apply a thin string of compound before starting the machine. Rotate the wheel by hand. Okay. Just taking an old chisel. So I put the advantages of the Tormek, which were on the front side, at the bottom part of the dripping plate. So we can sometimes still see what's so fantastic about the system. Now this indeed looks like a good place for the Angle Master. So we have now our Angle Master always at hand. So the next step is now to add water into the reservoir. So the system is now set up properly. Let's do our first grind. So we have this old Stanley, number 3. So the angle mask can be used what the actual angle is of the cutting edge. So 25 almost fits, 30 gives a perfect fit. 35 is too wide, so it's 30 degrees. So the disc is completely new, so it's 250 in diameter. And I will put the angle at 30 degrees. So the Angle Master is now properly set up for 30 degrees. Right. So we're going to use the SA77 for the grinding. So now we're going to adjust the handle in order to have the proper angle of 30 degrees. So in the book they explained where you should put the end stops to prevent the knife from getting off the grinding stone, and I couldn't find them, but they're actually already on the tool. So this is the one which is the adjustable end stop which you put over, and this is the end stop which is fixed on the end of the bar. So let's put on the tool. So you should have at least about 6 millimeters, so this is about the distance that you need to have. So this is the lowest position. Now the angle tool works quite well, let me show you. So here you see a nice example of how the Angle Master works. The diameter has been set to 250. It's a new grinding stone, so it's 250 millimeters in diameter. The angle I want to put is 30 degrees, which I measured. And you can see now that the angle still has to increase. So I will now turn the adjustment knob on the handle to make a proper fit. So this is a very easy way to set up your system. So here you see that I need to go up because we still see some opening. So with the adjustment screw I'm now raising the bracket. So this is the right angle. So I'm now fixating it with the two screws that fixate the bracket. Now I can do my grinding. So let's now do the fine dressing. Immediately a completely different sound. So let's do the paper test. Cuts all right, but not as sharp. It runs right through it. So let's give it another run. course it up. So I took it out, so I need to readjust the angle, of course. This is it. You can just see the stream of light coming through. You can clearly hear the rough grinding effect. So after the second time I can clearly feel the burr, which was not there before, so it was clearly not enough that I did on the first run. It's already an old planer, so clearly it needed quite some sharpening. So let's now go to the honey wheel and remove the burr. So this is how the water looks after sharpening, and here you can really see the effect of the magnet, because it really indeed collects all the metal parts. So I've thrown away the water and you can really see that all the metal is being condensed here around the magnet, which are taken out of the water this way. That ensures a clean grinding stone and also preventing metal particles from sticking to the surface of the stone and thereby disturbing the sharpening process. All collected here at the magnet. Which you then can use to scrape it out, I expect. Yes, there it goes. So this way also very easy to clean. Of course always store the stone dry so it doesn't get deformed. So let's now put the knife back into the old Stanley. So the new knife has now been mounted. Let's give it a run. So as you can see, nothing wrong with the old Stanley. So even though it's already quite old, ready again for some new woodwork. So the Termec T8 is now up and running. Did the first sharpening of this Stanley hand plane. The results are very good. Now sharpening tools is not my hobby, so I tend to leave them as long as possible unsharpened, which is not a good thing, but I simply want to spend my time in another way than doing sharpening of the tools. So I think the Termec is a very nice tool for people who don't like metal sharpening like myself. It makes those type of things even fun to do. So I hope you enjoyed the video. Thanks for watching and see you next time.